This is the honey badger. Watch it run in slow motion. It's pretty badass. Look, it runs all over the place. Whoa, watch out, says that bird. Ew, it's got a snake. Oh, it's chasing a jackal. Oh my gosh. Oh, the honey badgers are just crazy. At nighttime, the honey badger goes hunting because it's hungry. Look, here comes a fierce battle between a king cobra and a honey badger. I wonder what'll happen. Look at this. There's the honey badger just eating a mouse. And then look, get away from me, says the snake. Get away from me. Honey badger don't care. Honey badger smacks the shit out of it. And the snake comes back and it lashes right at the honey badger. Oh, little does the honey badger know, FYI, it's been stung. It's been bitten by the snake. So while it's eating the snake, ew, that's disgusting. Meanwhile, the poisonous venom is seeping through the honey badger's body and it passes out. Look at that sleepy fuck. Now the honey badger is just gonna pass out for a few minutes and then it's gonna get right back up and start eating all over again because it's a hungry little bastard. Look at this. Like nothing happened. The honey badger gets right back up and continues eating the cobra. How disgusting. And of course, what does the honey badger have to eat for the next 3 weeks? Cobra.
Honey badger is such a badass. But if I recall, when NASA wanted to test a biological specimen that could, like, maybe survive in the vacuum of space, you know, the cell-crushing power of space, like in the movie 2010, Honey Badger was all like, no thank you, I'm busy, call me later. So, good luck up there. What extremophile came rushing? Which one was like, hey... Like, who do you think it was? I was like, I can take that on. It was Water Bear. He's like, oh, let me say goodbye to my cousins and my little moss pool and go take a space flight. Sure enough, in 2007, they let him out for 4 days into space with no, like, you know, like it wasn't a little microscopic spacesuit or anything. He was just freestyling out there, floating around. And he got back on board and he's, shit, that was fun. Let's party. It's like, you know, Water Bear don't care. Water Bear's a microscopic little creature, and they can be found all over the world, from the Arctic to the Antarctic, and high mountains and deserts and cities and backyard gardens. In order for them to do life stuff, like, I don't know, badass shit like swim around, eat shit, make babies, they need at least a film of water surrounding their little Water Bear bodies. But sometimes their little moss pads, leaf litter dens, or lichen laboratories dry out. The water can be gone, but Water Bear's like, I don't care, shit, I'll beat this drought and go into my cryptobiosis. That's what a badass he is. He can go into cryptobiosis for 120 years, and then as soon as you give him a little bit of water, he jumps up and shouts, surprise, I wasn't dead, let's party! I know, 120 years is a long time, but like, whatever. In fact, they're like, hit me with organic solvents, ionizing radiation, vacuum, extreme pressures, 10 times beyond the bottom of the ocean, whatever, I'm Water Bear. I'm Water Bear, I don't care. Water Bear, he's so cool. I love Water Bear. Scientific name for him is tardigrade. Look at him there, he's like swimming, he's like moving around. He has extra legs, he has more legs than a real bear. Real bears are kind of badass too, but there he's like, oh, is he trying to kiss this? No, they don't kiss. They're too badass. There is another one. This is a different microscope. He's like, he looks green. And he's eating that shit. He's like, that's nasty. But he's eating it. He's like, I'm going to eat this shit. Okay, I don't care. Whatever. I'm going to swim around and I'm going to go make babies and... Some people think that maybe they came from outer space, because why would anything on the planet evolve to withstand so much? Their little cells have to go through, fix their little DNA and keep it from, I don't understand the biological shit. Look at his little legs, he's like, I'm a little water bear, I'm swimming around, isn't he cute? So cool. Like, he's so cool that when Honey Badger is at home, I was digging and is eating cobras and watching Doctor Who, Water Bear is up in space doing science for NASA in an experiment called tardigrades in space. And that's like TARDIS for short. How cool is that? Yeah, that's Water Bear. He don't care.